Well, we're just about to set out on the first Reef Rebels tour with a bunch of mooring open-minded participants. We're going to show them a bit of the reef, though the weather for the first couple of days is looking pretty terrible. But we're also going to show them a lot of data, both sides of the argument, and we're going to let them make up their mind. It should be a great time. So we're here on the first day of the Reef Rebels tour of the Great Barrier Reef. We're going to see a little bit of the reef. We're going to see a whole lot of data. And we've got a brilliant group of participants who are going to look at all that and decide what they think about the Great Barrier Reef.
Looking forward to hearing both sides of the argument.
Third year marine and environmental science student.
Working in the agricultural industry in North Queensland.
Before going out to look at the reef, there was some background data to look at, like the fact that the coral cover was at record high levels in 2022 and had not been badly affected by the recent bleaching events, or that large amounts of coral certainly die occasionally, especially due to waves from cyclones, but also from crown of thorns starfish. Reefs are constantly changing systems. Next day it was off to Moore Reef. The weather was terrible and there was even some doubt if the boat would go out at all due to strong winds. The water was not as clear as usual and the lack of sun washed out lots of the colours, but the coral looked good. This fella decided he was the star of the show. Most corals on any reef are not the brilliant colours of the glossy brochures and a beige or brown. But these corals are phenomenal for their intricateness. This reef was classified as severely bleached just a few months before, but there is almost no dead coral here. In a big cyclone, which occur in any other part of the reef roughly every couple of decades, the waves would smash these corals, but they are wonderful today.
And what was it like?
It was beautiful.
Next day was down the coastal plain into the wonderful farmland of far north Queensland. Although most people have heard about the possible impact of climate change, farmers have been blamed for damaging the reef for decades. We needed to see for ourselves. But first to a very special place in the rainforest. Okay, so guys, we've come to the rainforest, which doesn't sound like it's got anything to do with the reef, but there are similarities in the sense that it's a phenomenal ecosystem with incredible biodiversity, but it's also one which goes through cycles of, you know, crashing and the rest of it, not as often as a reef. So if you looked at some of this rainforest, 10, 15, 25 years ago, it would have been completely smashed by a cyclone, and you get that regeneration. Same on the reef, except the cycling tends to be more rapid. So a lot of the Australian ecosystems go through this, the crash and the regrowth. And if it keeps on recovering brilliantly after those natural crashes, then you know you've got a very resilient, healthy ecosystem. And this is about as resilient and healthy ecosystem as anywhere in the world, here in the rainforest. And I would argue similarly with the Great Barrier Reef. We make a stop at Pinjin Hill, and the river in Innisfail is looking murky from all the recent rain. Next stop, Peter Jackson's farm. Pesticides from farms are often blamed for killing the reef, although all the measurements show they are in too low concentrations to be even detectable with the most sensitive scientific equipment on the reef itself. Mud from soil erosion is also blamed for damaging the reef, although there is very little evidence for this. The reef is a long way from the land.
I'm quite surprised that the politicians and public servants know so little about the reef. They haven't made the effort.
And so you've made your own wetland, which you have cormorants and all sorts of animals and tortoises and various other things in barramundi. So clearly this water here can't be
too bad. In fact, it must be brilliant. Even though it's grown in groundwater from your farm, supposedly with all this poison that they accuse you of. And yet over the Great Barrier Reef is way over the horizon. So how on earth can you be damaging the Great Barrier Reef when you have such a verdant wetland right close to here?
I think particularly these young ones.
Yeah.
They need to be able to judge for themselves and not have it put into their head by somebody who's got those other beliefs.
No, you're right. And that's why we're taking these Reef Rebel participants to see the farms and to see the other side of the store.
Yes.
We take a break at Cardwell and last stop at Hinchinbrook Lookout before we settle in Townsville for the evening. Stay tuned for the next half of the trip